This is Josh Colson, the owner of Auburn Muffler and Auto Repair in Auburn, Washington. Josh is going to explain his unique application at the muffler shop today.
All right, I've got a 2000 RX-7 with turbo on it, and it had this cast iron flange with this very restrictive cast iron outlet that I've taken and cut off, and I'm going to weld on a 3-inch piece of regular muffler shop aluminized tubing. Weld this to the cast iron with the SSF 6 silver solder rod. And I've already done a short section of it here. I'm going to go ahead and weld the rest of it.
Always make sure to prepare your base metal by cleaning or grinding before starting your brazing process. Josh is using an oxyacetylene torch for this job. You'll notice that he's aiming the torch in the direction of the cast iron, as the cast is thicker and needs more heat applied before bringing both metals up to brazing temperature. He's hitting back and forth while looking for both metals to turn to a dull red. Now, propane and map gas can be used on these metals, but you would need the right torch tip. The little brass tips that sometimes come with your propane bottles really aren't for this application. You can find much better tips at your local hardware store. Did you see the rod ball up and roll off the part? This is what happens when we add too much heat to the base metal. It's common when using the oxyacetylene torch, as it gets very hot very quickly. If you've used oxyacetylene, you know what I'm talking about. The SSF6 works best at a dull red color, which is around 1150 degrees Fahrenheit. After this, Josh changed the torch tip from a number 4 to an ought tip, and that worked much better. Now, if you're still having a problem with overheating when you're moving to a smaller tip, just make sure to turn your oxygen down a bit. That should help you out a lot. After adjusting the oxygen, notice the SSF6 flowing beautifully onto both the cast iron and the steel. We're going to let the parts air cool naturally before we do any machine work. Notice the sizable gap that the SSF6 is able to repair. When built up, it actually looks like an arc weld and as strong as a weld at over 70,000 PSI. The rest of the part is welded and ready to install into the RX-7. He always makes sure to paint all parts before installation. It looks like Josh has another happy and satisfied customer. If you're in the Seattle-Tacoma area and need an honest mechanic for exhaust, muffler, and engine repairs, stop in and see Josh at Auburn Muffler and Auto Repair. You'll see his one-of-a-kind drag racing classic car out front. Speaking of happy customers, you too can pick up the SSF6 at muggyweld.com. Thousands of shops in North America and across the planet are using our unique silver braze by ordering it online. Have a great day and be nice to people.